สวัสดีค่ะ So this video we're gonna look at how to calculate the pH during the titration. I made this topic into two parts of the video นะคะ This is part one. Before we move on to the calculation, just make sure that you know all of this. If you don't, you have to go back to Chapter 1 and Chapter 2 to find out, นะคะ These are some topics that you must understand and be happy to write equation and get the idea of some calculation involve equilibrium. First thing, you need to be able to identify strong acid or base from the weak acid or base. We learned already that strong acid and base completely ionize in water, where weak acid and base partially ionize in water. And because of this partially ionization, we can derive the acid and base ionization constant or Ka and Kb. This is the equilibrium of the weak acid. Any weak acid ionized in water will produce hydronium ion and its conjugate base. So the Ka is equal to the hydronium ion concentration multiplied by the concentration of conjugate base divided by concentration of the weak acid. For the base, ionize in water and give its conjugate acid and hydroxide. So Kb is concentration of conjugate acid and hydroxide ion divided by concentration of the weak base. I said many times already that you need to write the corresponding K properly. Ka relate to hydronium ion concentration. Kb relate to the hydroxide ion concentration. And very important, we are going to calculate the pH value. pH value can be calculated from negative log of concentration of hydronium ion only. So the key point here is whenever you are asked to calculate the pH of the solution, you need to find out what is the concentration of hydronium ion in the solution. Next thing, we are going to talk about the titration and pH during the titration. So stoichiometry calculations is important as well. You need to be able to understand the mole ratio of substances in the balanced chemical equation. And this relationship between number of mole, volume, and concentration of solution is very important as well. Most of the time, well, we are going to work with the concentration of solution in molarity, and that is related to number of mole and volume like this. Molarity equal to number of mole divided by volume of the solution in liter, mole per liter. However, in the titration, we work with the volume of solution in milliliter. So the volume in milliliter and the number of mole can be changed into millimole. If you set up the number of mole in millimole instead of mole and use the volume in milliliter instead of liter, you still come up with the concentration in molarity anyway. So we're gonna use this concentration equal to millimole divided by milliliter in this video, นะคะ. And remind you again that acid-base neutralization reaction which occur during titration can be written according to this. A mole of acid react to B mole of base, produce salt and water. Depending on the type of acid and base, the pH during the titration will be calculated according to the substance that are present at that point during titration. Are you ready? Okay, let's start on the calculation of the pH during titration. The pH during the titration can be separate into four groups like this: pH at the start of the titration, pH before equivalence point, pH at equivalence point, and pH after equivalence point. This relate to the pH curve like this. At the start of the titration, if you have a pH curve like this, can you recall the type of titration here? Is it between strong or weak acid and strong or weak base? This is the pH curve of the titration of strong acid with strong base. Okay, if you can recall it, that's very good. Strong acid is your sample. The pH before adding any titrant in would be the pH of strong acid itself. So this is the pH at the starting point. When we add titrant, which is the strong base, in, the pH start to increase. And this is the pH before equivalence point. When we add titrant continually to add the titrant in until we reach equivalence point, this is the pH at equivalence point. We add titrant just a little bit more, just a little bit more. The pH change very much and continue to increase to be the pH of the strong base itself. This is the pH after equivalence point. So you have to understand how to calculate the pH in the four stage of titration. And this video, we're gonna look at this type of titration, the pH during titration of strong acid with strong base. pH during titration, as we mentioned earlier, we can divide into four stages of titration. All of them, we need to calculate pH. We have to think about this. pH is equal to negative log concentration of hydronium ion. So in all of this stage, we need to find out what is the concentration of hydronium ion. So which means that we have to ask ourselves, what are the substances that present at that point of the titration? Okay, let's have a look at this titration of strong acid with strong base. This is the example. We use 25 milliliter of 0.100 molar hydrochloric acid. This is our sample. We will titrate this with a strong base, that is sodium hydroxide, concentration 0.100 molar. Calculate the volume of sodium hydroxide needed at equivalence point. This need stoichiometry of the neutralization reaction. Hydrochloric react to sodium hydroxide, produce salt, sodium chloride, and water. Mole ratio is 1:1. So we derive this mole equivalence equation. Mole of acid equal to mole of base. Find out the volume of base needed to reach equivalence point. We did this many times, okay? So V of sodium hydroxide is 25 milliliter. So any volume added before this gonna be before equivalence point. After this, gonna be after equivalence point. Now, look at this dehydration at the starting point. At the starting point, visualize it as this. These are just, I made this up so that you can follow it easier. Hydrochloric acid, sodium hydroxide produce salt and water. This is the concentration of acid. This is concentration of base. At the starting point, we have acid with the volume of 25 milliliter. We only have this present at the start. So what is the pH? I said we have to think of what is the concentration of hydronium ion, right? Because this is gonna give us the pH value. This is the strong acid. Strong acid completely ionized in water. So we know that concentration of hydronium ion must equal to the concentration of the strong acid itself. This is the monoprotic acid. So it gives one mole of hydronium ion. So that concentration is 0.100 molar. Now we know this, we can find out the pH. Okay, pH equal to negative log concentration hydronium ion, which make negative log 0.100. And that give the answer of pH equal to 1. You see, right? Next stage. Come to next stage before equivalence point. This is what happened. We add sodium hydroxide in. Let's assume that this time we add 5 milliliter. The added base is gonna react it with acid. And when base react to acid, it will produce salt, sodium chloride. And the total volume of mixed solution increases. Right now, it will be 30 milliliter. 5 of this plus 25 of the acid itself, the volume increase. This is very important point in dehydration. At each point, the volume of the solution would change. So the concentration of substance in here change as well. Right now, after this happened, at this point, 5 milliliter of sodium hydroxide added into the solution react with hydrochloric acid. The product is produced. At the moment, we have strong acid in the solution here and some of the salt. We want to find out the pH at this point. So, the strong acid would give hydronium ion. Salt, in this particular salt, strong acid with strong base gives salt that will not hydrolyze in water, the ions show no hydrolysis of ions of the salt. Because of this, we will find out how much hydrochloric or the strong acid is remain. Because the hydronium ion concentration will equal to the concentration of strong acid that is remain at this point. Okay, this is what happened. We should do this pattern of calculation like this, nakha. Find out the amount of substance after the reaction, the dehydration, neutralization reaction occur. So we can do a pattern like this. What is the initial amount of substances? What did we add? What has been changed? And what remained after reaction? The amount work by the amount number of mole. Because the reaction happened according to number of mole of substance, so at the initial state or the starting of the titration, we have 2.5 millimole of hydrochloric acid. We have 0 millimole of sodium hydroxide. Then we add at this point 0.5 millimole of sodium hydroxide. The reaction will occur between these two. Mole ratio is 1:1. So this is in smaller amount, it will be consumed, all of it. So change, the base is consumed, negative. Acid is also consumed by how much? By the same amount, because stoichiometry is 1:1, right? Negative, decrease. On this side of the product, one mole of the product must be produced as well. So you use reactant 0.5 millimole. Product must occur 0.5 millimole as well. So after reaction, you start with 2.5, use 0.5, remain 2 millimole. You add 0.5, use 0.5, remain 0 millimole. Nothing before and produce 0.5, so remain 0.5 millimole. For those of you who want to know how did I come up with this table, look at the stoichiometry again. So here is how you should do the calculation for number of mole. Remember, we start with 25 milliliter of 0.1 molar acid with 0.1 molar of base. And we learn about this relationship between concentration, number of mole, and volume. Rearrange this, we calculate number of mole equal to concentration times volume. So for hydrochloric acid, 0.10 molar, we have 25 milliliter that make 2.5 millimole. Same thing for sodium hydroxide, we have 0.1 molar, we add 5 milliliter, so that make 0.5 millimole, which is this number in the table. Okay. Then we only care about the amount of substance after reaction. So at this point, what do we have? We have 2 millimole of hydrochloric acid and 0.5 millimole of salt. Remember, at this point, the total volume of the solution becomes 30 milliliter. So we need to find out concentration of hydrochloric acid, right? For calculate the pH. Concentration of hydrochloric acid is now equal to how much of that? 2 millimole in the total volume of 30 milliliter. Do this with your calculator. Use the ratio, okay? Easier to type in. Use this button, and this is your answer, 0.067 molar. So at this point, 5 milliliter of sodium hydroxide is added into the acid. I didn't draw the burette here. Okay? We add 5 milliliter of sodium hydroxide from burette into this flask. sodium hydroxide is consumed out of it, produce the salt break up into ions which are not undergo hydrolysis in water. So the only substance that give hydronium ion is the hydrochloric acid. Hydronium ion concentration equal to concentration of the strong acid, which is 0.067 molar. What is the pH? pH is negative log concentration hydronium ion, which is negative log 0.067. Do this by the calculator. This is the answer. So pH is 1.17. Okay, let's have a look at the pH change before equivalence point. Right now, we are at the starting point. If we add sodium hydroxide in, the added base is reacted with the acid. We calculate pH from the remaining of acid. We find out the first point already, the pH change into about 1.17, right? Next, if we add more sodium hydroxide, what happened? See, more salt and less acid. pH will be increased to this point. We keep adding the base in. Same calculation pattern. Okay, another point. All right. Right now, we add the total volume of 20 milliliter of sodium hydroxide. The mixture now has volume 45 milliliter. At this point, what is the pH of the solution? At this point, what is the pH of solution? Right now, we only have strong acid and salt. Can you calculate the pH? Practice to do this by pause the video. Pause, nakha, and go do the calculation and come back when you are done. Here is the answer. What is the pH of solution when 20 milliliter of sodium hydroxide is added? We figure out what remains after reaction. We start with 2.5 millimole of acid. We added 2 millimole of base. We added 2 millimole of base. This time this, right? Make this millimole. The base is less than acid, so it will all consumed. So the acid is used in the reaction in the same amount because 1-to-1 ratio, number of mole, produce same amount of salt. Acid used remained. So this is the millimole of acid. Remember the volume is now 45 milliliter. 0.5 millimole divided by 45 make 0.011. molar, and that is concentration of hydronium ion, and that is negative log. This amount make the pH 1.96. Did you get it right? Now we look at the stage at equivalence point. This is what happened. We add sodium hydroxide base in, and this react to the acid, and all acid are used up now. The total volume is now 50 milliliter, 25 of the acid, 25 of the base. No acid remain, as well as no base remain. This is the stoichiometric proportion between acid and base. Remember, we calculate this. The volume of sodium hydroxide needed to reach equivalence point is 25 milliliter of base. Right now, we only have the salt in the solution. We have only salt in the solution. So the pH will be the pH of the dissolution of the salt. This particular salt break into ions that are not undergo hydrolysis in water. So no hydrolysis of ion. The pH will be pH of the pure water, that is 7. This is a tricky question for exam sometimes, because you have seen that there is no acid, no base. So you think that no hydronium ion, you cannot calculate pH. That is wrong. Remind you again, there is a self ionization of water in every aqueous solution, which means the pH would be that pH of pure water, that is 7. Move on to the final stage after equivalence point. This is what happened. No more acid in, we add base. We add base. Base will remain because it will not be consumed by acid anymore. So what we have right now is strong base and salt. Again, salt, no hydrolysis. So this solution became a solution of strong base. pH must be more than 7. And you see that the pH increase a lot. If you use phenolphthalein, right now you should see a solution change color. What is the pH of the strong base now? The question, what is the pH of solution when 30 milliliter of sodium hydroxide is added? Calculate the pH of strong base solution. Okay, this is what happened. We figure out what remained after reaction. Same thing, like the stage before. Okay, we start with 2.5 millimole acid. Right now we add 3 millimole of base. Now base is more than acid. So the acid will be all consumed and the base is consumed by the same amount. So we have the remaining base in our solution. The total volume changed to 55 milliliter. So concentration of base is now 0.5 divided by 55, give you this 0.0091 molar. And this is a strong base. Strong base. The hydroxide concentration will be equal to the strong base itself, which is this value. We have hydroxide concentration. We can calculate pOH, and that gives 2.04. This is not the pH. We need to calculate, work out a little bit more. pH is 14 divided by pOH, and that gives the pH of the solution. Okay then, I hope you got everything. The summary for this video. We learn to calculate pH during dehydration. This part, we look at the dehydration of strong acid with strong base. At each particular stage during the dehydration, we need to identify substance that present at that point. So we calculate the pH according to the substance at that point. At the beginning of the hydration of strong acid, this is the pH of strong acid. Before equivalence point, less acid remain. So we calculate the pH of the remaining of the strong acid. Less acid remains, so the pH will be increased. At equivalence point, this is the pH of salt solution. Salt that come from strong acid and strong base would show no hydrolysis, which means the equivalence point will have pH equal to 7. After equivalence point, it's easy. This is the remaining of the strong base. So we calculate pH of strong base solution. That's it for this video. I see you the next one. สวัสดีค่ะ